Hello, everybody. So we're going to be starting our Unit 5 writing assignment looking at Evidence A. And what we're going to do is we're trying to make and defend a claim based on evidence that inheritable genetic variations may result from. And then we need to figure out one, two, or three, which one applies to this picture that we're looking at. Okay, so over on your right side of the screen is helpful info to include into your explanation. So looking at the picture, we've seen this in Class Connect before. We're looking at radiation, we're looking at chemicals, we're looking at infectious agents. These are all external things that we apply or get into our bodies that can actually affect us at the cellular level. Some of these are choices that you make to your body, such as smoking, what kind of things that you're eating, what types of things you're putting on your skin, how much sunlight you're exposed to, et cetera, which can lead to permanent mutations causing disorders or cancers and things like that. When you expose yourself to these conditions, your cells being affected at the cellular level is ultimately affecting your DNA. And so what's happening to your DNA is it's mutating. The mutations in your DNA are then carried out as DNA is replicated, right? Remember we talked about DNA replication, as new cells are being created. So if a mutation occurs in one cell in one piece of DNA, and then the DNA is replicated, the mutation is going to continue to be replicated over time as more cells are formed, hence leading to cancers or disorders. Something that I want to mention about this is that genetic code, that DNA that's affected, and those replications that are occurring is occurring in our somatic cells. Remember, our somatic cells are our normal body cells, and they are not occurring in our gonads where our sex cells are produced. Therefore, environmental factors such as being out in the sun too long and getting skin cancer does not become a trait that is passed on to our offspring because those mutations are not occurring in our sperm cells or our egg cells. And so this is just leading to genetic variation that's occurring in each of your cells in your somatic DNA. All right, good luck. Put together a claim and defend it based on that evidence.